wasn't going to be the Appalachia I remembered, but... mutated animals, haywire bots, and... no people so far. We have to be ready to rebuild in... what I can confirm is... hostile territory. Fortunately, Vault-Tec was prepared. You see this? The cooking station, the stash box, the workbenches, all built with the camp. You need a home base out there. The construction and assembly mobile platform is designed to give you one. Just add resources, planning, and a little elbow grease. When you move your camp, everything you've built is stored, ready to be placed back down in the new area. Use this to establish a foothold whenever you're in unfamiliar territory. I've left my camp behind so you can use it. I know I'm breaking my own advice by not taking it with me. But after seeing Appalachia for myself, I need to make sure every resident of 76 has a safe haven they can start from. I'll make do without it. If it's still standing, the town of Flatwoods is further down this road. Find me there. This is the Overseer, signing off.
another visitor around here.
Tomorrow. Can we really trust them? You looking to join up too? I'm gonna join up and take on the wasteland.
We are all links in the chain, bound in brotherhood.
Thank you. overseer lady said more people would be coming. It's nice to meet you.
Overseer's log, town of Flatwoods. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations we expected. But there's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions, and its voice, angry, tortured. We are one. One what? Whatever happened here is beyond anything we expected. And we expected a lot. Before they were wiped out, the survivors called themselves the Responders. Looks like they were made of firefighters, police, emergency medical staff. They even have an automated system to teach people about treating water, food, survival. I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagined, but... someone's got to know where the missile silos are, and how to secure them. The Responders are the best lead we have. This is the Overseer, signing off.
For the responder training? Then you're not alone. A lot of people come here because of that radio message the responders left. That's what brought me here too. At first, I was planning to just do the training and move on, but honestly, I kind of like it here. I really enjoy meeting all the people that pass through and hearing their stories. Wait a minute. Are you one of those people who was in Vault 76? I knew it! I could tell just by looking at you. I've always thought that life in a vault must be so amazing, with the robots and all the machines and having everything you need every day. Best of all, you're safe, which, let me tell you, is a thing us outsiders very rarely get to feel. Though I guess you're one of us now, so that's all in the past for you. Go right ahead. Yeah, there's a couple of places around here that qualify as interesting. At least to me. The Agricultural Research Center is infested with feral ghouls and homicidal robots. But you can find some good scrap in there if you're up to it. The New River Gorge Resort to the east is the same story. Maybe, minus the robots. I found it in one of the houses. It fits great, and it's really comfortable and pretty durable, too. I'd also be lying if I said it didn't have some sentimental value for me. I've admired the responders ever since I first heard about them. What they stood for, helping people no matter what, that was really important. Me? There's not much to tell, really. I came in with Paige and the rest and stayed up at Foundation for a while. It was nice. But eventually I wanted to go my own way, you know? Get out and see some places I'd never seen, figure out who I am. When I heard the message on the radio about Flatwoods, I was curious to meet the responder, so I made my way here. I decided to stay here and see what else I could learn. That's pretty much my story. It's a community of settlers up in the mountains to the east. It's a nice enough place, I guess. That being said, it's a hell of a dangerous trip trying to get there. I barely made it out of the mountains alive. If I were you, I'd keep to the forest until you're ready to deal with some seriously nasty stuff. He's the closest Foundation has to a leader, I guess. I never got to know him real well, but he always seemed like a decent guy. Honest, reliable, cares about the people, that kind of stuff. Okay, what is it? No problem. Chloe looks after me. She's the best guardian a girl could have.
seems like a fine idea. So, hi, I am Kesha McDermott. When the bombs fell, I was in Watoga, coordinating a statewide science fair for that year's high school kids. And the theme was the future of energy. After the bombs, everything was pretty chaotic. Scavenging for food and fighting off rabid survivors. Oh, it was just a bad time all around. I found a couple of surviving kids from the high school whose parents didn't make it. And we holed up in a house in town for a while. After a bit, I was able to solder the circuitry in an old radio, and we tuned in to a broadcast from the responders. Oh, we were overjoyed. The trip from Watoga to Flatwoods, it was rough, mind you. The kids and I ran into a group of assholes in the mountains who stole our food and water. I can't tell you how happy I was to find the responders in Flatwoods. Tents for everyone, open kitchens, medical supplies, protection. We were safe. They had a problem, though. Their water sources were contaminated heavily. People were boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination, and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse, too. It's going to take time and care, that's all. Well, time, care, and science. log. Town of Flatwoods. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people... Overseers... Let's call these personal journals. Not an official log, just... something for me. The Agricultural Center. One of my first posts with Vault-Tec. I was so excited because I used to come to this same farm when I was a kid. I remember one year, at the Autumn Festival, me running through the corn maze, going every which way, Mom and Dad yelling after me to slow down. Wasn't gonna happen. I guess I was always hitting my fast. Couldn't just be a Pioneer Scout, I had to make troop leader. Couldn't just be a good student. I had to have straight A's. God, I miss those early days. Just being a kid. The three of us, our simple life. Our simple house. I wonder if it's still standing.
Anything goes. my first interview with another survivor, Kesha McDermott. She found me trying to break into a Nuka-Cola machine and, showed me a different way. So, Kesha, can you tell us a bit about how we can make sure our water is safe for drinking? We'll try to keep it to the basics for training purposes.
Oh, it's not complicated, really. Find water and strain out any big particles and chunks. Then, boil it in a pot over an open fire for a minute or two, then let it cool. Should be fine. Like making tea, right?
Reverend Delbert Winters here, born and raised in this very town. Lent my own church to the responders for their outpost here, and, you're welcome. The responders are on a true mission, you see. Helping folks through thick and thin, till the heavens open up again and take us all up anyways. When this all happened, I figured like most, it was time. This was the end, but it wasn't. We're still here. At first, I thought it was a mistake, that we was missed, forgotten. Maybe we did some wrongs. Didn't give enough to charity, maybe. Didn't praise his name, even in the worst of times. Maybe thought some things that ought not to have been thought. So I asked him. I asked how? Why? I fought your wars on Earth. I'm ready to fight them up there by your side. Then, in my despair, I saw some survivors eating raw rat carcass behind a dumpster. Gotta cook that first, I warned them. Seemed obvious. We tried but got sick, they said, covered in their own filth. I realized right then and there that I was being tasked. From then on, I built kitchens. Cooked good food, fed anyone who walked up with an empty belly, and I was thankful for my task in life. Thankful. Next time hell or high water land in my stoop, I'll be swept clear away with it. But until then, let's share a home-cooked meal together, all right?
Make yourself at home.
I did.
Thank you.
and welcome to the first of Headmaster Mort's edutapes. Today we're talking about your camp. Now, former Vault resident or someone who killed a Vault resident, let's start off with the basics. Placing your camp. When plunking down your camp, C-A-M-P, that's an acronym, for the first time, remember to... Remember to take the lay of the land. Consider the grade of the terrain, general defensibility, and proximity to your surroundings. Could that cliff edge be used to protect your flank? You bet your chops it could. Once you've found the perfect spot, it's time to move on to the best part of working